Well, I'm sure that you must have studied the literary concept or literary device very widely used in almost every literary work. That is imagery. So it is in your SYBA or in your other classes, TYBA, you must have studied imagery. Imagery means to use figurative language. And this figurative language is used to represent objects, actions, and ideas in such a way that it appeals to our physical senses. It appeals to our eyes, ears, then skin, nose, tongue, etc. These are our physical senses. We talk about five senses. So it appeals to all these physical senses. And the term imagery can be defined as the verbal stimulation. It's a kind of stimulation. No, when you see something that stimulates you to go for the action. For example, if you happen to see a very tasty food, your hunger is stimulated. You feel like eating that. So that is stimulation. So it is the verbal, by using words. Verbal means words. The writer uses such words that stimulates your sensory perception. Okay, means the word imagery has a kind of visual bias. Imagery call on all five senses. It appeals to you, all five senses. Of course, imagery can be taken as only visual, something which can be seen with eyes. But it is beyond that, Mitch. It includes all five senses. Based on that, we can talk about visual imagery, auditory imagery. Then you have got what we call this olfactory imagery, which is related to smell. You have gestaltic imagery, which is related to your taste, we can say. Okay, so you have got thermal imagery. Thermal is related to your skin touch, we can say. So this is how we can talk about different types of imagery. So in simple words, we can say that imagery is a form, no? In simplest form, we can say, sorry, imagery recreates a physical sensation in a clear, literal manner. And the term becomes more complex when a writer employs metaphor. Means for imagery, they use different kinds of figures of speech. And the writer may employ metaphor and other figures of speech, such as simile, etc., to recreate experience by using metaphor, by using metonymy, by using simile, other figures of speech. The writer tries to recreate experience. You experience it. When you hear those words, that particular sense, can be experienced by you people. Now, let's take again a very famous example. It is a Marathi poem by Balkavi. Hirve hirve gar galiche, Harit tronacha makhmalice. Now, when you hear these words, hirve hirve gar galiche, you can see the picture of the greenery. That is visual imagery. Means the picture of greenery is created in front of your eyes. At the same time, when you hear the word gar galiche, so you can feel the touch, the coldness, the smoothness, gar and galiche. Okay, there is a use of alliteration as well. An alliteration, gar galiche. At the same time, by using this alliteration, the writer is the poet is appealing to the sense of touch, to the sense of eyes, we can say seeing, your visual imagery, your visual senses are appealed. You can see the picture of the green lush garden or green lush surrounding. त्या मखमालीवरती फुलराणी ही खेळत होती. Now when you say त्या मखमालीवरती, you can see the green lush garden or a grass etc, and on that someone is playing. So this is the use of personification. Now Phoolrani refers to a flower, but the poet has attributed human qualities to that flower. Okay, he considers it as a human being, and by doing so, he's trying to create a picture of a very happy dancing girl. That is visual imagery. At the same time, you can see the movement of that girl, khelat hoti. So this is kinesthetic imagery. You can imagine the movement of that girl. So this is how imagery is used by the poets, by the writers. So usually imagery is thought that it is thought that imagery makes use of particular words, okay, that create visual representation of ideas in our minds. Means when those words are used, the visual picture is created in our minds. When, for example, you hear the song Suhana Safar or E Mausam Hasi, in that song itself there are certain lines. O kaun hasta hai phoolon mein chupkar, bahar bechain hai kiski dhun par. So you can hear that dhun, that dhun can be heard, okay? Or you can see the picture of a smiling person. O kaun hasta hai phoolon mein chupkar. So you can imagine that, you can see the picture, the live picture is created in front of your eyes. That is visual imagery. At the same time, bahar bechain hai kiski dhun par, so you can hear the sound of music, okay? Pyare pyare ye nazare nikhar hai har kahi. So this is how a lively picture is created. So the word imagery is associated with mental pictures. And this idea is, means when we say that imagery is a mental picture, it is partially correct, not fully correct. Means to be frank, to be realistic, imagery turns out to be more complex than just a picture. It cannot be simply a picture. Now, when you read the following lines, you'll realize what I'm trying to say. It was dark and dim in the forest. So in this line, the words dark and dim are visual images. Means you can see the picture of darkness and dimness. And when you read the line, the children were screaming and shouting in the fields. The words from this line, from this sentence, screaming and shouting, appeal to our sense of hearing. Means it is not simply a picture, therefore. It is beyond that. It is something very complex. Screaming, you can hear the screaming of children, shouting of children. You must have heard that poem from Garwa, Un thoda jaast hai, dar varshi vadt, bhar una, paus giun, abhaal manat dadt, tari paula chalat rahatat, man chalat nahi. अंगात घामाशिवाय दुसरं कोणी बोलत नाही. इतक्यात कुठून एक ढग, समथिंग ऑफ द काइंड, आय डोंट रिमेंबर द लाइन्स, अँड देन देर इज अ कंपॅरिझन ऑफ विंड, वारा, सैरा वैरा धावत राहतो उन्हाळ मुलासारखा. सो सिमिलर इज युज, उन्हाळ मुलासारखा वारा धावत राहतो. So you can see the picture, you know, that visual picture is created. You can see a child to be running and wind is compared with that. At the same time, there is a movement, you know, that movement can be felt. Saira Vaira, that word appeals to your senses. You can see that that boy is not running systematically. You can see the, you know, calf of the cow as well. Vasru, the Saparata. So imagery needs the aid of figures of speech. Aid means help, assistance of simile, metaphor, personification, and even onomatopoeia. Onomatopoeia means a natural imitation of, no, the imitation of natural sound. When we say now, bang of the door. Bang, the word bang is an example of onomatopoeia. Okay. Meowing of the cat. So the word meowing, creaking, etc. are the examples of onomatopoeia. So in Marathi, dhadam, we say. When we say dhadam, that is onomatopoeia. So it is the imitation of natural sound. So in imagery, metaphor is used, simile is used, personification is used to create a picture, to appeal to the bodily senses. Now here are some examples from literature. This example is taken from Romeo and Juliet by William Shakespeare. So there, imagery of light and darkness is repeated many times in William Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet. Now you can see the example here. This example is taken from Act 1 and Scene 5 of the play, Romeo and Juliet. Oh, she doth teach the torches to burn bright. It seems she hangs upon the cheek of night like a rich jewel in an Ethiopia's ear. Sorry, Ethiopia's ear. So here, Romeo is praising Juliet by saying that she appears more brighter, radiant than the brightly lit torches in the hall. Her face is glowing. So you can see the picture, the torches which are burning, which are bright, and her face is radiant than the torches. Further, he says that the night, at night, her face glows like a bright jewel, shining against the dark skin of an African person. Okay, so night is a kind of, night is compared with, you know, Ethiopia. Ethiopia is a place in Africa that is a historical ancient place, and so she is compared with, you know, jewel, whereas night is compared with the African person with black color. So these are the contrasting images of light and dark, which Romeo uses to talk about Juliet's beauty. So this is how exaggeration can be used in many of, you know, Hindi songs, especially you come across exaggeration. So that can be an example of imagery itself. Exaggeration can also be used. That's what I'm saying. Okay, means by using these words, the poet tries to create the picture, mental picture, then it appeals to a senses. So this is how we understand the term imagery as used in literary criticism.